Today, I'm going to show you how to make a photo slideshow in Microsoft PowerPoint that feels automatic. You may already know the basic way to create a slideshow in PowerPoint. You click Insert, then Pictures, and you can bring in one photo at a time. For example, you can open your desktop, find the folder of your photos, and then add them one by one. Or you could drag the mouse across all the images, press Insert, and add all of them at once. But there is a problem. Both ways are too long. If you need a PowerPoint photo album, I'm sure you want it quick and simple. You don't want to waste time putting each picture on a different slide. So, instead, let me show you the easiest method. Stick with me until the end because this PowerPoint tip will save you a lot of time and effort. You'll still go to the Insert tab, but instead of choosing Pictures, you look in the Images group. There is a button called Photo Album. Click the top part of that button and a new window opens. This is where the magic for building a PowerPoint photo slideshow begins. Here, you can bring a whole group of pictures at once by just clicking the little button that looks like a disk to pick images from your computer. A file window opens, so you can explore and find the folder. It's better if you already have your photos saved in one folder so they are ready to go. You can click and drag to select your pictures, and that works fine if you only have 10 or 15. But what if you have 100, 200, or even more images? Dragging would be very annoying and slow. Here is a shortcut. Simply press Ctrl plus A on your keyboard. That selects everything at once that is in your folder. Then, just click Insert. Now, notice the difference. The photos don't get dumped into one slide. Instead, they appear in a list inside the photo album window. On the right, you can preview each picture. Pretty neat, right? This is one of the fastest ways to make a PowerPoint slideshow with multiple pictures. These photos I'm using are free tech images from different platforms. They are royalty free, and that means anyone can use them. If you want to learn more about finding free images for your PowerPoint slideshow,
type the word free in the comment section.
Inside the list, you can reorder the photos by selecting one and moving it up or down. You can even highlight several at once and shift them together.
If you don't need an image anymore,
you just click on it and hit remove. You will also get some light editing tools. For example, you can rotate a picture, make it brighter, or even make it darker. Nothing too fancy, but useful if you want small adjustment in the images. On the left, there is a button to insert text. If you click it, a new text slide gets added. Later, you can type whatever you want, maybe a title or a note. There is also an option to make all your photos black and white. I'll skip that for now, but you could try it if you like that kind of style. Before you hit create, I want you to see some layout settings for your PowerPoint slideshow. At the bottom, there is a drop-down for picture layout. By default, it says fit to slide, which means each picture fills the slide as best as possible. But you could change that to show one picture per slide, two per slide, or even four in a tile. I like fit to slide, so I will stay with that. Once you're ready, then click create. Now PowerPoint builds the slideshow for you. It gives you a title at the beginning, which you can edit. Then every single photo is placed on its own slide automatically. There is also a text slide, but personally, I don't find that one very useful, so I usually delete it. Now, you might have noticed the letterbox effect. Black bars on the top and bottom or sides. That happens because PowerPoint does not want to stretch or distort your images. If I resize too much, the photo would spill off the slide. If you really want to fill the slide, you can grab the handles on the side of the picture and stretch it, but sometimes it still looks okay. You decide what works best for your PowerPoint slideshow. Another thing, PowerPoint automatically sets a background. If you don't like that, you can change it. Go to Design, Format Background. Choose a solid fill color, maybe blue, white, or anything else. Then hit Apply to All if you want the same color on every slide. Personally, I prefer the black, but it's nice to know that you have these options. Now, let's make the PowerPoint slideshow more fun. Go to the Transitions tab here. You can add effects like fade, push, or cut. Click the little arrow and you'll see even more, like curtain, origami, or paper airplane. I'm going to pick vortex for my slideshow. Once you like it, you click apply to all, so every slide uses the same transition. There are also effect options to play with if you want a variety. Let's test it. I'll start the slideshow. There is your title, then the first photo, then the second photo with a smooth vortex effect. Looks pretty cool, right? Okay. But what if you want the PowerPoint slideshow to run on its own, like at a senior 6 leavers party or alumni get together? You don't want someone standing there pressing buttons. Yes, here's the trick. Go to transitions. On the right, you'll see advanced slide. By default, it says on mouse click. That includes hitting the spacebar or using a remote. But you can also set it to advance automatically after a certain time. For example, try setting the time to 1.5 seconds. Then click apply to all, so every slide follows that timing. Now, when you run the PowerPoint automatic slideshow, the pictures move forward on their own without you touching anything. That's good. But at an event, you don't want the slideshow to just stop when it reaches the end. You want it to loop forever. So here's what you can do to it. Go to the slideshow tab, then click setup slideshow. In that window, check the box that says loop continuously until escape. Now the PowerPoint slideshow keeps repeating until someone presses escape. To test, let's skip to the last slide. After 1.5 seconds, it transitions back to the beginning and the loop continues. If you found this tutorial helpful, tap the like button. Don't forget to subscribe for more easy PowerPoint tips and tricks, because I post new videos every week. See you in the next one.